Can PRP delay or stop hair loss due to DHT? Can PRP delay or stop hair loss due to DHT if PRP is done every 4 to 6 months? Can I reduce or stop the hair fall due to DHT by doing PRP at regular intervals?
Thank you for your question. You've asked a question without submitting a photo, but you're asking, can PRP delay the effect or stop the effect of DHT? And by doing a schedule of every 4 to 6 month injections to try to disrupt the DHT effect on hair. Well, I can certainly help you understand the response to this question, because I can certainly understand the confusion as to what causes hair loss. And since DHT is what most people are familiar with, I could see why there would be kind of an interrelationship assumed there. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers. This is a system we developed in our practice as a non-surgical alternative to hair transplant for men and women with thinning hair who come to us from around the world. We have a lot of experience with treating hair loss, and DHT and PRP and other modalities are often discussed every day, all day long in our practice. So let's begin with understanding DHT a little bit. Basically, this was derived out of research done that ultimately created the drug Propecia, or finasteride, which is the generic. And basically, DHT, or dihydrotestosterone, is converted by an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. The effect of DHT is actually through the circulation as it goes to the hair. So in order to really decrease DHT, you have to do it systemically. In other words, you have to take a pill. You have to take a drug every day. Then that drug is finasteride, and that's only relevant for male pattern hair loss. Now, because the causes of hair loss are very poorly understood, with the only awareness that we have scientifically as being a factor is dihydrotestosterone. However, it is clear that dihydrotestosterone is not the only thing that's causing hair loss. There is a large percentage of men, and statistics such as we often quote, are when it comes to finasteride, 60% of men will respond, 40% will not. Now, you have to think, if DHT were the actual cause of all male pattern hair loss, it should be like 100%. And so we had the opportunity to see the difference and the distinction between what PRP does, as well as a new material that's used for stem cell-based wound healing called acellular matrix. Now, understanding that PRP has multiple effects on the hair follicle mechanism, and recent studies in dermatologic research has actually shown different pathways which PRP can stimulate to stimulate hair growth, but it's not a DHT blocker. So you can improve the expression of hair loss by regular injections of PRP, but you are not doing anything specifically to DHT. Now, interestingly, several years ago, when we were doing a lot of hair transplants, we were trying to establish an improved approach to try to get the donor area to heal better, and for the hair grafts to also heal better, because there's actually a challenge with hair transplant. Grafts don't always all survive, and the donor area has a tendency to scar, especially with this traditional strip approach. And what was a serendipitous observation was that thinning hair became thicker when we used platelet-rich plasma acellular matrix. And so acellular matrix became something that I felt I can work on to develop a system to try to stimulate hair growth. And based on what we've developed over time, and essentially with a lot of interesting challenges being overcome, we developed a system and we call it Trichostem Hair Regeneration, or hair regeneration. And basically with this method, we're able to, with an injection, stop the progression of hair loss, reactivate hair that's not growing, and induce the shed of thinning hairs so thicker hairs can grow in. Now, how is this different from PRP? Well, PRP, which I use a lot in my practice to help people with acne scars, with wrinkles, with dark under-eye circles, for all kinds of ways to improve skin quality, complexion, we use PRP a lot. It's been my observation that PRP alone will only stimulate hair growth for a short term, and it doesn't stop progression. Our clinical experience with our method of hair regeneration, with a single injection, we've been able to keep people from losing hair as well as regaining hair for the duration of 5 years for 99% of patients, both men and women. We always do our best to try to customize to each individual patient because people come with different degrees of hair loss as well as different genetics. And so, but I would say that essentially the stability of this procedure has been remarkable. And interestingly, because of a lot of fear about the long-term sexual side effects of taking finasteride, we have basically been able to do this without the benefit of a DHT blocker. So what has been essentially revealed through this development is that there's more to hair loss than just DHT. Now, I would certainly support the concept that if someone can tolerate taking finasteride and do hair regeneration, there's actually a synergistic benefit. We've had many patients who took finasteride before coming to us because they were still losing hair. They probably significantly slowed down their hair loss by using finasteride, but they were still losing hair. So taking finasteride alone was good. When they came and did hair regeneration, they had more growth and they had greater outcome, better outcome in terms of the overall scalp coverage and real significant improvement. So I would say that the question of mechanism is not really valid, but the question of approach to maximizing saving your hair, stopping your hair from going away, and regrowing your hair is now an opportunity for you to further explore medical therapy, PRP, and the technology we developed, hair regeneration, PRP, acellular matrix. So learn more about these, and hopefully you'll be able to find a solution that fits your lifestyle. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question. Thank you.